off to Neverland.
Hey there, guys.
We're going to
walk some.
Go for a little walkie walk and show you around a little bit, show you the sights and sounds of Fort Lauderdale, what we've been doing. Okay. So this is our daily ritual.
Somebody ate fish and you smell it.
So yeah, we're gonna show you guys around. This is our digs. This has been our digs here for what? How long?
Gosh,
over a year.
Yeah, a year and 3 months almost.
Yeah, we've been Fort Lauderdale-ites for that long.
Wow,
that's amazing. I mean, if you're gonna be stuck anywhere, Fort Lauderdale's not a bad place to be stuck at.
Nah, you know? Not at all.
I mean,
it's a lot of ritzy people, though. You know, what we like to say in Spanish: "Tiran a pelo más alto del culo." It means they fart higher than their butt. You know, and they, they want to be the haves. You know, they have more than they need.
And they do have.
Oh yes.
As you can see, there's a lot of haves in this area. You know, I mean, it's a nice area. This isn't the nicest part.
No, there's even nicer.
You know, there's nicer stuff out here.
One of the things that people don't realize that the more material things you gather, the more your soul disappears, because things tend to like eat up at your insides, because you become a slave to your junk. In my opinion, you know, to each their own. But
I mean, you can only have so much stuff before it just starts to accumulate and just pile, and you have nowhere really to put it, you know? And then you have to get a storage unit to put it all in a place, you know? It's like
your garages get packed.
Yeah.
And they never see the stuff that you buy, because the beauty of a lot of humans is that they buy stuff, they play with it for a little while, and then that's it, it's really done.
We'll go the typical way that we usually go. We're gonna show you guys around Victoria Park.
I also want to create an analogy, the same concept of people, you know, just collect stuff and their garage gets full. They do the same thing with food, and they just stuff their bodies with thing they call food, which is really not food, and they just get bigger and bigger and bigger, and then their health starts to deteriorate. That's the same concept when you just start overindulging in materialistic goods, and then you need a 5-bedroom house, and you need 4 and 5 cars, and a closet full of clothing. You know, all that stuff takes your energy away. It zaps you. It zaps your soul.
Now, look at this. I mean, we've been walking around here, and, you know, I mean, it's normal for us to see this, but it is so pretty. I mean, the trees here are just so amazing. They're older and stately, and, you know, as much as people talk about Florida being hurricane prone and everything, I mean, that tree,
it's been there forever.
I mean, it's been there for eons of time. We'll show you guys more stuff as we keep going. Look at the coconuts right there. I tell you, that's one of the things that we are not going to be seeing on our journey as we leave Florida. Oh wow, look. Are those mangoes?
Yeah. The mango tree, she's like losing all her mangoes.
She's losing her mangoes. It's a tragedy.
Yeah. I mean, a ton of them have been.
And that's the other thing that we're not going to be seeing as well, is that mangoes don't really thrive anywhere north of here, north of Florida, and South Florida, really.
Pretty,
Central Florida, maybe.
Sad to see. I mean, I know that they've been doing stuff to trees, all the chemtrails and all the.
Look at that. See, this is what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Some people live like this.
Yeah. And then you got other people that are homeless. So somehow, that's an imbalance in my book. You know, how can people sleep at night and they're cozy $1 million beds when they know that other people have none. And, you know, I know a lot of people say, well, that's capitalism for you. And, you know, some people work really hard to get what they have. That's all very much a fallacy, because some people are born into tragedy, into a situation that's less than perfect. And other people, yeah, some people do work hard for what they have, but a lot of people are born into their riches. And
you were saying
that some people are born into it, and some people, you know, just get a break, you know. And I mean, what do you think about that? What do you
I think that people are born into their situation, but when the haves are born into a situation and they don't know anything but having stuff, taking things for granted, they don't really appreciate things like people who have had to struggle to get, you know, simple things, you know.
The thing is, a lot of people, you know, live their lives based on material goods and what they're going to gather throughout their lives, instead of making goals of self-improvement, of making human connections, of doing something for the planet and doing something for others. The drive becomes self-centered and to gather more and more things. And that to me is just, you know, for instance, you got this house right here. I'm walking in Elvis's, they even have, you know, mannequins and a Hummer. I mean, talk about wasting gas.
Yeah.
And leaving a lot of footprint behind.
And this house has been abandoned ever since we've moved here.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful house, but most people in South Florida would never be able to afford it. And that's the thing about South Florida, is that it has the greatest separation between the haves
and the have-nots.
And the haves are, and this isn't even half of it. This is just kind of
like, still considered middle class.
Yeah, this is still middle class. But even the middle class here in Fort Lauderdale does quite well for themselves, it seems like. I don't know what they do for a living, but, you know, they do quite well.
And you got the other side of the coin, where you got people that are homeless, like this morning when we went to work out in the park. A bunch of homeless people.
Yes.
You know. But guess what? They're happier than these haves, you know?
Yeah, because these haves have to worry about things. That's why they have these fences.
Yeah, they have to worry about people stealing their shit. And they have to worry about the tax man, and they have to worry about being able to keep up with all this stuff.
They have an electric fence.
Yeah.
You know, a gate that opens up to their posh landscaped home.
And I'm sure they have cameras, and it's like you have to live a life of paranoia. I mean, all of them have these fences and these electric things.
They had a beautiful Christmas display here.
Yeah, they did.
They did it up pretty nicely. But yeah, we won't be seeing much of that nice palmage.
I remember last year when we were gone.
Florida is a beautiful place because you see stuff like that just growing naturally.
And they've got little parks everywhere and back park. Us looking type of houses.
Yeah. All kinds of houses, beautiful Victorian looking houses like that. And then they have these modern houses, nice sidewalks. Over there is a canal, and there's homes across that canal. And the streets go in only one way, and you have to walk back out or drive back out the same way you came in. It's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I remember last year around this time, we were walking a bunch.
13 miles at one
13
point.
13 miles, no kidding. And we were just enjoying being able to walk and stuff and see stuff. And I just remember just how many beautiful homes there were, you know, just walking around and taking a look at stuff. It was just breathtaking, really, you know. But as beautiful as that was, it still wasn't as pretty as what we left, Silver City, because anything natural,
of course,
is always, always going to be anything artificial.
You know, it's like, you got a lot of beautiful greenery here in Florida, and you can't take that away. Some of the trees are amazing.
We love that house. Look at that. It has like a water fountain coming out of it, a waterfall.
The mountains have such life to them as well. I mean, you know, basically that's why we're doing what we're doing, because we don't want to just have one particular thing. We want to be able to experience the many different things, the oceans, the mountains, the different trees, you know, just, that's why this nomadic lifestyle suits us just fine, because we don't have to pick and choose.
Nope.
We can experience it all without no boundaries.
No boundaries.
Beautiful flowers. That's why they call it Florida.
Flor.
Flor meaning flower.
Flower. Safe community.
Very.
I mean, never once did we feel unsafe walking here, day or night.
Because we walked both in the day, during the day and during the night.
Yep.
We put a lot of miles on our shoes.
Sure have.
Living here. It's important. Just flowering. You see that white one over there?
Where? Where?
Right over there.
Oh, yeah. I can't really see her. Oh, she's flowering on other parts, too. Oh, yeah, this is the one that you're talking about. Uh-oh. This is what we affectionately call the Disney House.
Yes.
Because it looks like something that would be in Main Street, USA,
yep,
at Disney. And I remember we were asking somebody that was here, what did we say?
Oh my God, how many bedrooms does it have? It must have a lot. Oh, not really, just a standard. The guy was, looked like he was from Pakistan. Just a standard, typical American home. Four bedrooms.
Four bedrooms?
And I'm like,
in there?
Because there's no way such that a lie. Has four bedrooms.
There's no way.
No way. You just lied to me, dude. But yeah, in the back there, and you see the little palm tree.
I think there's four bedrooms in that garage on that one
maybe.
Side.
Yeah.
But I mean, come on.
Yeah,
seriously.
My cars.
This is such a nice road. I mean, this road reminds me of Coconut Grove.
Yeah.
Like
that's when we originally came down
came
Florida
to visit.
To visit my sister. And, except that Coconut Grove is a lot more expensive and a lot more crowded. I prefer Broward County, less congested, and not as pricey as Miami areas.
Yeah, it's not as expensive.
No.
I mean, it's expensive, don't get me wrong, but
Miami, you know, you're really looking at
premium,
major, you know, price jump from Broward County to Dade County, especially Coconut Grove, Coral Gables, you know.
Can always count on a lawn service being out here.
Oh my gosh, yeah. Nothing more annoying than, you know, the sounds. I mean, you figure they can make machineries that do not create such noise pollution.
But no.
No, they just have to...
They don't.
...generate noise and gas smell and just traumatize the living daylights out of vegetation.
Look at that. Another house.
It's like something you've seen a plantation.
Yeah.
You know?
Except they're from Iowa.
Yeah. But...
I think so.
This is what is it called again?
Osmo Mobile, I think.
Osmo Mobile, and it actually allows you to, it's a glorified, excessively expensive selfie stick, but it's not really a selfie stick.
It's a Steadicam.
Yeah.
For people that don't have a Steadicam. So it just makes things smoother. It has a gimbal that stays, keeps the camera level. I mean, people are using lots of drone footage, and this is kind of the same concept as a drone, except this doesn't fly, obviously, unless I were to be carried off or something. But it has a self-balancing gimbal that allows it to keep the shot steady, so that if you're running or walking, it doesn't get anyone sick.
And you've actually tricked the machinery to be able to actually put a GoPro on it, because it's actually meant to be used with a phone.
Yeah, like an iPhone or a Samsung phone. Or my LG phones, yeah. They work on here too.
Yeah.
But I like a GoPro because it's a wider shot, and it gives me the ability to just, you know, although I can't see what the camera's shooting, it's still a wide shot, so it's not a big deal. And here we are in Las Olas. We're not going that way, but if you go this way, the beach. See, it says, the sign says beaches. But we are not going that way. We are going this way towards downtown. Leave before they ask.
I know.
Would you like to? Can I help you?
No, I'm just looking for you. For your luxuriously expensive prices.
We never ate anywhere on this strip because it's so expensive.
Plus, they ain't gonna cater to our vegan needs.
No.
And be oily food.
Oh, look, there's a place coming.
El Camino. Tequila Bar. Brunch, lunch, and dinner. Another Mexican restaurant. They're going to give that one Mexican restaurant a run for their money.
Yeah. It needs it.
Yeah.
They're
it's
probably
way expensive.
Super overcharged. This is the famous Las Olas.
Las Olas.
It's a pretty, pretty cool little strip.
Yeah.
Tourist tries.
Yeah.
People get ice cream here. But this, couldn't get it.
Yeah.
Heading towards downtown Fort Lauderdale.
You got museums,